Hello. I think I picked the wrong day to come, only because it's pouring down with rain. I'm on the Isle of Wight. Behind me is the last running, because the others are in a pretty bad state of repair, as we'll discuss, to ride the 1938 stock X-Tube trains from here to Shanklin on the Isle of Wight, the Island Line, for one last time before they go at the end of this year. This is your last chance to ride the tube trains on the Isle of Wight.
But before we take our journey today, let's have a little history. The Isle of Wight once had a much more extensive network of railways, with the first line on the island being opened between Cowes and Newport in 1862. That was followed by a separate company opening up their railway in 1864 between Ryde and Shanklin, which was extended to Ventnor in 1866. It was in 1875 that the connection between Ryde and Newport was made, and then by 1879, the line between Newport and Sandown was in place. In 1882, a short spur off to Bembridge was also built, to be followed by a new major railway in 1889 heading west out of Newport that went to Yarmouth and Freshwater. And then the last railway on the island to be built was an extension south of Newport that went to a new separate station at Ventnor that was completed by 1900. And although some of these had fallen by the wayside by the 1950s, it was of course with the beaching cuts in the 1960s that the axe really fell, leaving just the Ryde to Shanklin line, even though that was also recommended for closure. A small part of the Ryde to Newport line still also exists today as the Isle of Wight Steam Railway.
Vicky and I, of course, didn't come here in all the stations 2017. Also, not with me that day, do you remember, was my friend Chris.
Hello.
You live in Portsmouth on the mainland, so it's literally just over. You come on the hovercraft,
I come on the hovercraft.
So you've come for one last bash as well.
Indeed.
As we call it, and we'll chat to you about your memories of the Isle of Wight and riding these trains and stuff. There's only one unit running. Seven is in the depot being patched up. Eight is running. Six is dead, apparently. And the new ones, what class number are the new ones?
484s.
484s? You've seen the photo, haven't you?
Yeah.
One's here on the island somewhere.
It is.
All right.
If you want to know more about the old District Line trains that have been converted to run on the Island Line, then there's a whole other video you can watch here where I spent the day at Viva Rail, the company working on them, and chatting to them about how their battery-operated trains work. The link is in the description below.
Told me, is this true that the maquette is actually ex-Metropolitan line? Is it like a really old net line? But, I'm going to stay on my fingers. The little flat down seats are still here. With the old Network Southeast livery. Remember that? So I'm just going to perch. Chris is out riding the line today. My friend Martin, whom has been in some of my videos before, he's going to get on at Brading. I've just seen on Twitter, I've got word that Matt Streeton, who is the voice of GTR trains, is also here riding the line out with his friends just for one last bash. We're going to have trouble with the, look at the raindrops on the lens, I'm so sorry. So we've picked a real day for it because it is raining. Although actually it kind of rains and then it kind of stops and then it rains a little more and then it stops again. A minute ago I was chucking it down. But we're going to have some fun because I'll put a link in the description. There is something called Railcam Live. It's my friend Simon. They stick up railcams. We can watch live views of trains all over the place. And he stuck one on the roof of the Royal Esplanade Hotel so that we can all watch, it's raining again, we can all watch the last 38 stocks rumble by. And so I've told people that I'm about to go on and wave. So I can't hold my camera and my phone. So we'll try and do it. Okay. So we're walking out now. Chris and Martin are here. Where do you think it is? You think it's up there? So if we just... So this is the moment. I'll cut this with the footage. So Simon, give me the footage. You cut that footage with this footage.
It'll be awesome. And we'll just wave. I hope you're zooming in right now, Simon. Keep your distance, please. Triple wave. That's it. It's really raining. Can we go and get the train, please?
Yeah, let's go and get the train.
That's it. Bye. St. John's Road, still raining. Over there, is that 6 or 7 in the depot? I'm going to try and come back and get a shot of the depot from the street later. It's so bumpy, I love it. the noise of the engines. The engines are, of course, what was revolutionary about these trains. On the underground in 1938, that they were the first trains to have all the engines, all the gubbins, underneath the floor. Before that, the 1920s standard stock, like half the front carriage, was taken up by the engines. And the Isle of Wight actually had those trains. People just think it was these tube trains, but actually this is the second lot of tube trains. Back in the 1960s, when they got rid of steam, it was the old 1920s underground standard stock that came across the island and ran here for many years.
Steam trains had run on the island from the start in 1886 right up until the end of 1966. Here a service is shown in the last week of their operations, at which point 1920s London Underground standard stock took over the working of the line and ran for almost 70 years, until the early 1990s, which is when the current 1938 tube trains, which are now being replaced, were brought over and started their life on the island.
Memory or thing that you'll miss about the 38s, Chris?
It's their absolutely appalling kind of ride. It's lovely and bouncy, and you know, it's a bit like coming up the Northern Line from Morden to Kennington. It just lots of bounce. These are the first trains that I can remember riding on the Underground as a child, and I remember coming on these just before they were phased out.
I've made it to Brading. My friend Martin is here, but I've also met somebody else called James. James, you're a local.
I am,
so
yes.
So you live on the island. So you've ridden these trains for how many years?
Well, I've been here 15 years now, but I've been commuting quite a lot recently. Yeah, pretty much every day if I have to go up the pier.
Are you going to be sad about the old trains? Are you excited about the new ones?
Bit of both, really. I really love the 38 stock, but it's quite interesting to see different underground trains here.
And can you tell us, because I understand they're going to move the footbridge and reinstate the passing loop here at Brading, is that correct?
Yes, so for my understanding, we're going to get the new passing loop back here so the other platform will come back into use. I understand that the foot crossing at the south of the station will now be at the north of the station instead.
Taking shelter under the footbridge. You're saying it's so old now, they only let one person on it at a time, because occasionally the signal box is open up for people to visit. The other speculation we've heard is that, as well as the passing loop reinstating the second platform here, they might also upgrade the bay platform, the third platform, and maybe park one of the old trains in there to sort of add it as an attraction to the signal box. But then we've also heard that the Epping to Ongar Railway might be getting one of the 38 units, and they'll keep on running, so there'll always be a 38 unit running up there. I'm sure you can speculate this to your heart's content down in the comments. Please do. I've caught up with Martin. We've come to get a shot of the tunnel because St. John's is just down there. As we discussed earlier, the tunnel was built later and they've had issues over the years with tunnel clearance and leakage.
The tunnels used to flood regularly, so they raised the track bed to try and ease the flooding problems. Which obviously restricted the height of the stock, which is why they have to use the tube stock they do. Contrary to popular belief, apparently the district line stock will fit, but the issue was the width more than the height. But they must have overcome it, so... Yes.
You got an umbrella?
I wish I did.
Do you think the one nearest us there is, that's 9?
483009.
And the one other side of it?
Right at the back is 483002.
Two. So where's number 7?
7 will be in the shed looking all immaculate and pristine.
If you listen very... Oh, it stopped. Just as I hit record, from inside the shed of the depot, you can hear the compressor of the Viva Rail D78 unit. So it's in there. The new train is in there. We just can't see it.
Do you know one thing they haven't got, and that's proper strap hangers. So this is the closest you can get to like grabbing a strap hanger handle and bouncing along. It's so bouncy!
With it still pouring down, we went to the end of the line at Shanklin to shelter from the rain and grab a cup of tea. We had to wait an hour for the next train, but when the line is upgraded next year with the new trains, it'll be possible to run a much improved half-hourly service.
It's after 3:30, it's at John's down below. The sun is setting down there on the other side of the bridge. It's a train that's got a little bit of graffiti on it. The good news is that it's stopped raining. Hooray! We're just gonna walk down to Esplanade from here. It'll probably get dark, and there's another familiar face that I need to go and catch up with. So actually, on the day that we've come, I'm so glad it's stopped raining, the catamaran, the fast cat, isn't running. So the trains are running to the pierhead for no reason. To my right, the most amazing sunset is happening. I've taken a quick walk along the pier, and I just want to stress, this is it. This is your last chance to see slash ride the 1938 tube trains. We're told the first weekend of January, which I think is January the 2nd, is when the line closes for 3 months. Should be back up and running in April of 2021 with the D trains. So if you want to ride the old trains, you're running out of time. Turned up. Can we see Matt in the dark? So Matt, the voice of GTR. Matt, why did you come out to see the train for the last time? And the train is there. Look, we timed it.
Just to say goodbye and have one last ride on this vintage, lovely 1938 stock. Had to come out and just. I mean, it's just so sort of unique. You know, the fact that these were running around during the war, and that, you know, what are they, 80, 82 years old now, and just with their lovely sort of wood panelling and just, oh, they just. Yeah, it's one of a kind. Shame to see them go, but you know, they need to retire.
Matt, my feet are wet and yep. I'm really cold and it's dark and I want to go and have some dinner. But nice to see you.
Yeah, nice to see you as well, Jeff.
So time to go home and a trip back to the mainland on the hovercraft, which by the way is the last remaining commercial hovercraft service left anywhere in the world. And alongside the pierhead, which stretches out into the water, with the old tube trains soon to be replaced by the new old tube trains running alongside. The last day of operation for the old 1938 stock is set to be the 3rd of January 2021, after which the line will close completely for 12 weeks, with it scheduled to open again with the new trains in April.